Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and we're going to talk about all the movies that are out there this weekend. Every weekend there's four, five, six, seven. We don't even have time for them. So I'm going to start with the good one. And the good one is called Rachel Getting Married, starring Anne Hathaway, as a girl home from rehab for her sister Rachel's wedding. She calls herself Sheba the Destroyer, the Harbinger of Doom. She is trouble, one long drink of trouble. And this is a performance that is so different than anything you've ever seen her do. This is nothing like The Princess Diaries, nothing like The Devil Wears Prada. She is trouble, annoying, everything on earth, and yet you root for her. In this kind of serious drama, you watch her in this weekend, and you watch she and her sister hating each other, and you root for her. The movie is directed by Jonathan Demme, who did Silence of the Lambs. There's no horror in this movie, but there's a great deal of feeling, a great deal of what goes on inside a family and how a family screws you up for life. I'm saying this is one of the better movies you're going to see all year, and Anne Hathaway will be on the list when they come up with the five nominees for Best Actress for the Academy Award. So look, I was good. I was nice. Now I'm going to be not so nice and talk about Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist. Love Michael Cera. We all loved him in Superbad. We all loved him in Juno. He's playing something of the same kind of part in this movie, and Kat Dennings is in it with him, a new actress who I think is spectacular. But what are they doing? They're roaming around the five boroughs in New York in his yellow Yugo, looking for something that I can't even remember, and I just saw the movie. It is so quiet that you come home from it and forgot that you saw it. You need a little more than that, and this movie doesn't deliver. So what else is there? There is a movie called Flash of Genius, starring Greg Kinnear, in another performance that I think this year the Academy has to look at. But what is he playing? Greg Kinnear told me, I asked him, what is this movie about before I saw it? And he said, it's about the guy, the true story of the guy who invented the intermittent windshield wiper. Are you kidding me? I mean, it's so boring. An idea, who cares? It's like reading patent law. But no, he makes the movie into something kind of classic, like Jimmy Stewart in Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. It's the little guy who gets his patent for that windshield wiper stolen by the Ford Motor Company and spends 20 years trying to get credit for it, money for it, but mostly the credit for it. And Kinnear, not funny. Nothing in this movie is comic in that sense. It's a serious performance, and it's award caliber. So I've said too many good things, and I'm tired of it. And since I initiated last week the scum bucket to put in the worst movies out there, I'm throwing in a movie called Beverly Hills Chihuahua. I know you're going to see it. I know everyone is going to see it. I know this weekend this movie will make $50 million and be as if it were a Dark Knight kind of thing, because everyone wants to see an animated puppy going to Mexico with the voice of Drew Barrymore and talking to other puppies with every Latino cliche you can throw in the book. But I could tell because I hear people on the streets of Manhattan saying to me, did you see Beverly Hills Chihuahua? And they say Chihuahua over and over again. I'm taking Chihuahua and throwing it in the scum bucket. And I'm Peter Travers.
Ay, Chihuahua.